So now we are going to see about how to calculate the liquid ratio. The other name for liquid ratio is quick ratio, or it is also called as acid test ratio. Okay, so there are three names. First one is the liquid ratio, quick ratio, or acid test ratio. So what is the formula of calculating the liquid ratio? That is liquid asset divided by current liabilities. So this is the formula to calculate the liquid ratio. Okay, so we have to know what are all the items which is included in the liquid asset and what are all the items included in the current liabilities. Okay, so see, so quick asset, it is also called as liquid asset. So formula is to calculate the liquid ratio equal to liquid asset divided by current liabilities. Okay, so see, liquid asset is also called as quick asset. Okay, so we have to know what are all the assets which is coming under the quick asset or liquid asset. That is short term investment within the period of 1 year, that is 12 months, cash and cash equivalents, and other current asset. Other current asset is included, but we should not include the prepaid expenses. Except that is prepaid expenses should not included in the current asset. Okay, and come to the trade receivables. In trade receivables, we should include bills receivable and debtors. And if there is any provision for doubtful debts, that amount is to be subtracted. That is, in order to calculate the trade receivable, we have to include bills receivable and debtors, and we should subtract the provision for bad and doubtful debts. And short term loans and advances and marketable securities. So these are all the items which we have to include to calculate the liquid asset or quick asset. And there are some of the items which we should not include while calculating the liquid asset. That is the inventories. Inventories in the form of raw materials, finished goods, and stores and spares, and prepaid expenses. So if there is any prepaid expenses, this expenses to be subtracted and it should not be included. And unamortized expenses, that is the fictitious assets. What are all the unamortized expenses? So there are certain items which is called as fictitious assets, that is unamortized expenses. Share issue expenses, discount on issue of debentures, loss on issue of debentures, and underwriter's commission. If these items are appearing in this balance sheet, these items should not be included because these items are fictitious assets, that is unamortized expenses. Okay, what are all the items? Share issue expenses, discount on issue of debentures, loss on issue of debentures, and underwriter's commission. Okay, next. The next one is work in progress. Next one is stock in trade and loose tools. These items will not be included when calculating the liquid assets. Okay, so these are all the items we have to include, and these are all the items we should not take into consideration while calculating the liquid asset or quick asset. Next one is the current liabilities. What is the current liabilities? The liabilities which are repayable within the short period of time, that is the period of time is within the 12 months, that is called as the current liabilities. So this liabilities includes the short term borrowings, that is payable within 12 months, and trade payables, which is included bills payable and creditors. and other current liabilities, that is called as outstanding expenses, interest due, current maturities of long-term debt, an unclaimed dividend and calls in advance. So these are all the items coming under the other current liabilities and short-term provisions. Okay, so these are all the items coming under the current liabilities. So be thorough in this concept. What are all the items we have to include in the liquid asset or fixed asset? What are all the items we should not included in the liquid asset or current asset? And what are all the items coming under the current liabilities? Okay, so now we start the sum that is relating to the quick ratio. How to calculate the quick ratio or liquid ratio or acid test ratio? So in this sum, it's a debtors, bills receivable, prepaid expenses, inventories, sundry creditors and bills payable. By seeing the item, it's very easy to identify, that is prepaid expenses and inventories we should not take into account while calculating the liquid asset. So we have to put the X mark, that is this item is not included. So sundry debtors and bills receivable is called trade receivable, and sundry creditors and bills payable are called trade payables. Okay, so very simple sum. So first we have to write the formula. What is the formula? That is quick asset or liquid asset divided by current liabilities. So first we have to calculate the liquid asset or quick asset, that is trade receivable, which is called as debtors plus bills receivable, and current liabilities is trade payable, that is creditor plus bills payable. Okay, that is 1:1. We have to write the liquid ratio in the form of 1:1. Okay, so next see the 18th sum. It is given in the form of balance sheet. So the balance sheet, shareholders fund, non-current liabilities, current liabilities, and in asset, non-current asset and current asset. In additional information, inventories include loose tools 40,000 and other current asset include prepaid expenses worth rupees 40,000. So they asked to calculate the current ratio as well as the quick ratio. Quick ratio is also called as liquid ratio or acid test ratio. Okay, so there are three names: quick ratio or liquid ratio or acid test ratio. So first we write the formula for current ratio, that is current asset divided by current liabilities. Okay, you see the current asset. In current asset, there is also some of the items. What are all the items we have to include and what are all the items we should not take into consideration? So see the current asset. So in current asset, what is your current asset? The assets which is in the form of cash or cash equivalent, and it is to be converted into the cash in a very short period, that is within the period of 12 months. That is called as current asset. So current asset include current investment, that is investment in this form of instrument, government securities, debentures, partnership firm, preference shares, trust securities, mutual fund, but the period should be within the 12 months. So any investment which is realized within the period of 12 months is called as current asset. Okay, and see the inventories. Inventories means stock. So we have to consider the inventories, but while considering the inventory, we should not take loose tools. So if there is any loose tools, stores and spares, we should not include in the inventories. Okay, so second item. So we should not take loose tools, stores and spares. Okay, the next trade receivable, the same procedure that we studied in the liquid asset. We have to include the bills receivable and debtors But if there is any provision for doubtful debts, that amount is to be subtracted. Okay, this is the third condition. Next one is cash and cash equivalent. So in this, cash in hand, check in hand, marketable securities, cash at bank and draft in hand. These are all the items which is coming under cash and cash equivalent. And short term loans and advances, because this amount is realized within the period of 12 months. Okay, and other current asset, that is prepaid expenses, interest receivable, accrued income. Accrued income means that is outstanding income, and advance tax. This amount will also be included in the current asset. Okay, and see, while calculating the current asset, if there is any unamortized expenses and losses, which is under the heading other current assets, this unamortized expenses and losses, that is fictitious assets, are coming under the heading other current asset. Okay, ma'am? So this unamortized expenses and losses will not be used for the purpose of calculating the current ratio. So what is the meaning? If there is any unamortized expenses and losses, this amount should not be taken to account. That is the meaning. Okay, so how to calculate the current asset? Current asset include all the investment only for the short period, and we have to include the inventories. While calculating the inventories, we should not include loose tools, stores and spares. And trade receivable is calculated by adding the bills receivable and debtors, and if there is any provision for doubtful debts, that amount is to be subtracted. Okay, and cash and cash equivalent and short term loans and advances and other current asset, it's also to be included. Okay, other current asset to be included. And what are the other current asset? That is prepaid expenses, interest receivable, accrued income, that is earned but not received. It is called as accrued income, and any advance taxes. Okay. So now we can go to the sum. So see the sum, current assets divided by current liabilities. So see the sum. So in this, current asset means where we have to see, these are all the non-current asset. Okay, so as per the formula, current asset divided by current liability. So where we have to see, that is the current asset. So current investment, we have to include inventories. So what is the rule in inventories? If there is any loose tools and sports and spares, that amount should not be included. But see the additional information. In inventories, the loose tools 40,000 is included. So this 40,000 is to be subtracted from 1 lakh. Right. Next, trade receivables. Next, cash and cash equivalent and other current asset. So in inventories only, this 40, so we have to subtract this 40,000. Okay, next, come to the current liability. So current assets, we calculated current liability. Current liability, we have to see this column, that is trade payables, that is creditors, and short term provisions. So these two items will come under the current liabilities. Okay, so see how they calculated current asset. They included current investment, so inventories. They excluded the loose tools amount 40,000. So totally inventories is 1 lakh. In this, the loose tools is included. So 40,000 is included. That is, so 60,000 only we have to take as the inventory. Okay, the next, trade receivables, full amount we have to take into account. Next, cash and cash equivalent we have to take. Another current asset also we have to take. So what are all the current liabilities? Trade payable plus short term provisions. So from this we can able to calculate the current ratio. So next come to the liquid ratio. It is also called as quick ratio and acid test ratio. What is that? Acid test ratio. Okay, well. So what is the formula? That is quick asset or liquid asset divided by current liabilities. So how to calculate the liquid asset? Current investment plus trade receivables. So see, in this, to calculate the liquid asset, we should not include the inventories. We should include only the current investment, trade receivables, cash and cash equivalent. So see the rules. If you are seeing the rules for the liquid asset, so we have to include only the trade receivables and short term investment, cash and cash equivalent, and other current asset should be included, but we should not include the prepaid expenses. We have to apply this condition while we are calculating the liquid asset. Okay. So current investment is 2 lakhs, trade receivable is 1,50,000, and cash and cash equivalent is 1,10,000. See, so this inventory amount we should not take into account while calculating the liquid asset. Okay, so in other current asset, so as per the rules, while calculating the liquid asset, we have to include other current asset, and if there is any prepaid expenses, that prepaid expenses is to be subtracted from the other current asset. This is the rules. I'm right. So the other current asset is 40,000. So in this other current asset, the prepaid expenses is 40,000. So other, what is the meaning? Other current asset is 40,000. So this full amount 40,000 is the prepaid expenses. Okay, so this amount is to not be taken into account while calculating the liquid asset. Okay, so three, that is the current investment, trade receivable and cash equivalent alone to be taken into account while calculating the liquid asset. Okay, next come to the current liability. The current liability is the same calculation. There is no changes while calculating the current liability. So what is the current liability? See the sum, that is creditors and short term provisions. These two items are coming under the current liabilities. Okay, this is a very simple sum. So next sum, see, the current liability is given as 1,60,000, liquid ratio is given and current ratio is also given, and they asked to calculate the quick asset. Quick asset is also called as liquid asset or acid test asset, and they asked to calculate the current asset. So very simple formula. First you have to write the formula. What is the formula? Quick asset divided by current liability, that is 1.5:1. Okay, so liquid ratio equal to liquid asset divided by current liability. So in this 1.5:1, and current liability, just we have to apply in the formula, that is 1.5 by 1 equal to liquid asset by what is the current liability 1,60,000. Okay, so cross multiply. We have to apply the mathematical rules. That is, liquid asset equal to 1,60,000 into 1.5. So from this we can calculate the liquid asset. Okay, next come to the current ratio. What is the formula? Current asset divided by current. Here there is a printing mistake. Current asset. Okay, so current asset divided by current liability. What is the ratio? That is 2.5 divided by 1 equal to current asset divided by 1,60,000. So cross multiply. We have to cross multiply. That is, current asset equal to 1,60,000 into 2.5. So 4 lakhs is the current asset. Okay. So very simple sum. So see the next sum. The current asset is 9 lakhs. Current ratio is given. Liquid ratio is given. They asked to calculate the amount of current liabilities, liquid asset and inventory. Okay. So first you write the formula for the current ratio. Current asset divided by current liability. That is 3 is to 1. That is, see, 3 by 1 equal to current asset. What is the amount for current asset? That is 9 lakhs divided by current liability. Okay, so cross multiply. Current liability into 3 equal to 9 lakhs. So current liability equal to 9 lakhs divided by 3. That is 3 lakhs. So we calculated the current liability. Okay, so now come to the, what is the formula for the liquid ratio? Liquid ratio equal to liquid asset divided by current liability. So what is the ratio? That is 1.20. Liquid ratio is 1.20 divided by 1 equal to liquid asset divided by, we already calculated the current liability, that is 3 lakhs. Am I right? Okay. So just we have to cross multiply. That is, liquid asset equal to 3 lakhs into 1.20. That is, amount is 3,60,000. So what is the amount for the liquid asset? 3,60,000, and we calculated the current liability as 3 lakhs. So we calculated liquid asset and current liability. So what is the third one? They asked to calculate the inventory. I'm right. So what is the formula? Liquid asset equal to current asset minus inventory. Okay, this is the formula. Because while calculating the liquid asset, we are taking all the current asset. I'm right. We are considering all the current asset, but we are not considering the inventory. Inventory in the form of loose tools, stores and spares. So only we are subtracting that inventory amount from the current asset. Keep in mind. So what is the formula? Liquid asset equal to current asset minus inventory. So in this sum, they asked to calculate the inventory. Okay. So inventory equal to, how to write? Current asset minus liquid asset. Okay. Current asset minus liquid asset. So what is the amount for the current asset? Current asset is already in the sum. What is the amount? 9 lakhs. Okay. 9 lakhs minus liquid asset we already calculated. That is 3 lakh 60,000. So the balance is 5,40,000 is the amount of inventory. Okay. So in the book it is directly given, but we have to do the sum by step by step we have to calculate. Okay. So see the next sum. This is the homework sum. Illustration 21 is the homework sum. You have to do by yourself. Okay. The same method. 21, 22, 23, 24, and 25. Okay. 25, 26, 27, and 28. So 26, 25, 26, 27, 28. The four sums. It is given as the statement. It is a statement sum. So you have to understand the sum. So the ratio is given, and they are giving the sum of the transaction is given. We have to write as a statement whether the liquid has, whether there is any changes, whether there is any improvement, whether there is any reduction in the liquid asset or not. We have to write as a reason what is the effect in the ratio and why it has happened. Whether it is decreasing means we have to write the reason. If there is improvement means we have to write as the reasons. If there is no changes in the ratio means we have to write the reason. So these four sums are the statement sums. Okay, so read the sum carefully, understand the sum, apply the formula and the concept in each and every transaction, and write the effect on the ratio, and write the reasons why there is the changes. Okay, so this four sums are the statement sum. So up to the illustration 28. Okay, this sums are related to the liquidity ratio. Okay, so before starting to write the sum, first you write the formulas, finish the formulas, and then write all the conditions. So it is in the page number 4.6. For the current ratio, this is the conditions. Okay, and for the liquid ratio, it is, these are all the conditions, and this is the formula for current ratio and liquidity ratio. So before starting to do the sum, first write the formulas, write the conditions, which is in page number 4.6 and 4.7, and then do the problems. Okay. Thank you, students.